going on, guys? It's Alex from Part-Time First Sergeant. In this video, I want to talk about APFT failures. There are a couple of folks online that were talking about people they know who fail multiple APFTs and yet they're still in the military. So to clarify the process real quick, the moment you fail an APFT or fail to have record APFT within a 12-month period of time, your command team should initiate flagging actions. So what does this mean? This means that you are ineligible for promotion, you are ineligible for awards, any favorable recognition. This is even certificate of appreciation all the way down to a coin. You shouldn't be receiving any favorable actions while you are flagged for APFT failure. Now, I don't know how this happens in most states, but in theory, if you have 3 for record APFT fails, your command team should be initiating your separation from the military. Now, how does it happen that a soldier fails multiple APFTs and still in the military? Well, there could be multiple reasons for that. One example could be that a soldier had failed the APFT, had a counseling session, and during the counseling session, the individual conducting the counseling discovers that individual has some, you know, personal hardships or injury that led to that failure, right? And then the soldier promised that he would improve and eventually pass the APFT. With that said, some command teams, they still should flag you for APFT failure, could elect to have diagnostics APFT, if your state allows for that, diagnostic APFTs, for you to have an opportunity to prove that you are working on your APFT and that you are improving over time. So no harm, no foul. You take several diagnostics, APFT throughout the year, you're still flagged, but you know, because those APFT are not for record, you know, your career is not in jeopardy. You still can't get any favorable actions, but with that said, you have an opportunity to improve yourself. In over 12 months, you should be able, or even 6 months, you should be able to pass your APFT. Now, if for some reason you got way out of whack, the problem, and you're unable to get yourself up to speed in 6 months to a year, you have deeper problems, right? So the problem didn't start with that first APFT fail. It started long before then, and that's something else that it's another discussion for another time. So with that said, you may see a soldier taking multiple APFTs almost every single drill, and that person is never removed. The soldier fails the second APFT, you know, that's not a good look. In the third APFT, the process should start for separation. Some states may even have two strikes, you're out rule, where you fail 2 record APFTs, they initiate separation orders. Now, once they initiate the separation orders, that paperwork doesn't just go out and then you're separated from the military. It still has got to go up the chain to the different echelons, and then essentially get to state, and then state is the one that processes the separation, right? So your commander initiates the separation, but your state is the one that processes the separation itself. That's the one that says you're no longer in the military. Another scenario could be that the soldier is in a process of clearing an MND, a medical non-deployable. They may not yet have a profile, or they may have a profile for some reason, and they still elect to take the APFT even though they don't have to. Or they are just taking an APFT not for record because their profile states that they're not required to take an APFT, but they take it anyways just to take it with the group and kind of assess themselves. You're not privy to that information, and that's why you're not seeing them getting separated from the military. A third scenario, the soldier has failed 3 for record APFT. The commander has initiated the process for separation, and state is still sitting on that paperwork, or it's still working its way up to state. So those are the possible 3 reasons. But nevertheless, remember, if you're flagged for APFT, that's a bad situation. If you have education benefits, the military may try to recoup your bonus payments, the payments that have already been processed, and you obviously cancel out whatever you were still eligible to receive in the future. So there are a lot of downsides to being flagged. So what I can tell you is that if you failed an APFT and it's a fluke, volunteer to take it immediately after, right? There's no shame in that. The regulation states that you can take it as soon as the soldier feels ready right? As early as a soldier feels ready and the commander agrees, which means that you show up to drill on Saturday, you take an APFT, you fail, and you say, you know what, that was a fluke, I don't know what happened, I tripped and I fell on the run, or somebody weren't holding my feet correctly, or I was doing the push-ups and my grader didn't accurately count my scores, but you normally would pass the APFT, bet, like, hey, I'll volunteer to take it on Sunday, right? And keep in mind that the folks that are administering the APFT on Saturday generally either take it beforehand, or they, you know, drills beforehand, or they take it the following day. So you may have an opportunity to take it on Saturday. And if those people aren't taking APFT, ask, it's like, hey, can we get three people from the platoon? It's only one person, maybe two people. You can just, round up a couple of folks that still need to take an APFT that for some reason they didn't take it the previous day, and administer the APFT with a small group of people. You need to finish it within 2 hours anyways, right? And it's only, one or two people. You can knock that out in less than an hour. Now, if you fail, then you know you failed because you messed up and you haven't been training, don't volunteer to take it the next day, because the next day means that you have a failed APFT too. And then third strike, you could potentially be out and you're jeopardizing yourself. If it's one of your soldiers, you should be running down that reason why that soldier's failing, and two, why that soldier's no longer out of the military, right? Because it's unacceptable and it's bad for morale, for the overall unit, where most of the unit is doing the right thing, and then you have one or two people not doing the right thing, and they get the same benefits as you. That's not good for morale. Thank you very much for checking out this video. Make sure you check out my other 2-minute drills and also my videos on retirement and promotion. All right.